just left our motel. We were just out for breakfast at a place called Sprouts in South Lake Tahoe. And then we are going to head to Emerald Bay this morning. So we're going to get a gondola up to the top to get the views. And I think apparently there's a brewery up there, so I think Si's probably going to have a beer up there, an early beer. We'll get some lunch probably. Then I think we're going to try and find a beach. So pretty chilled day, I think, hopefully. I'm not sure I'm up for another trek today. So I've got a freshly squeezed orange juice, and Si's got some kind of mango tango smoothie. Yeah.
Got bananas, but you don't.
I hate banana. I am a weirdo. You know that.
Mango, banana, orange juice.
Mmm. Yeah, those vitamins. Vitamins.
Vitamins. How am I supposed to eat it?
Put it in your mouth.
It's too big.
Smash it in there.
Oh, a little bit of cheeky tempo. Oh. And oh.
Oh, I won't film this.
And a bit of, sorry, focus. And a bit of avocado.
Driving this bit, guys. It's very literally on the edge of the cliff. So I just need to get a sneezing fit, and we're a goner, which is quite a terrifying thing. Oh, we've arrived at Emerald State Park.
Emerald Bay Overlook.
Oh, Viking Tom Trail, that's what we're after. Nearly there. So that's one side. And then over here, oh my god, that's Emerald Bay. There's a little island.
So
this
cool.
Is crazy. There, down there, can you see it?
Sorry.
The little island down there.
Oh, yeah. Is that the island they're talking about?
Yeah. We spoke to a local about going up on the gondola today, and just said that it's just, can you even hear me? I bet it's really windy. That just because the visibility is so bad because of the fires, it's going to be a lot of money and you might not get the views that you're expecting, so probably not a good idea to spend our money on that. So instead we've come to a place called Emerald Bay, and we've done a little trail walk down. And we're now at the beach, but we went to go and get a canoe because we really wanted to canoe. And they say the wind's too high and they've shut shop for the whole day. And they're like, come back tomorrow. We're like, we're not here tomorrow. So canoeing is off the agenda now, but we can't complain because I'll just show you what we're looking at right now. It's pretty sweet. Look at all these gorgeous flowers as well. Going in. Is it really cold?
Just stand here for a little bit.
Yeah. I'm going to put my feet in. Where is that? Oh my god. You're having a lovely time, son. Basking. Lovely time. Look at your toes. Let me confirm. That it's not great to get an RBS attack when you're out in a forest in the middle of that. I got there just in time, I found a port-a-loo. But yeah, a bit of a panic, but I could have predicted that, couldn't I? It was always going to happen at some point. So if you embark on a trek that takes you downhill quite a long way, do remember that usually that means you've got to go uphill to get back to your original point. So I was at the point now where it's physically pushing me from behind to get up there. Arrived at Angola Beach after a pretty mammoth trek again, and we've got some of their specialty fresh lemonade, and we're about to go in this kayak right here. Go for a little kayak.
Go for a little.
What do you call that? Go for a kayak.
Go for a little kayak.
Go for a row.
Yeah.
Go for a row. That's what we're gonna do.
We're being charged now, so
yeah.
As well, mate.
Are you gonna put your life jacket on? Yeah.
Walk it, have it with us. Yeah.
I'm gonna put mine on. I'm really scared. I can't really swim and I'm really terrified, and then the wind just blew us really far and I thought we were going to capsize, so I'm a little bit scared. But we're still alive for now. I actually can't wait for this to be over. Yeah, really. Oh god.
Okay, well let's...
Si is going to go on now solo kayak because I was obviously hindering his adventuring. Be safe out there, man. Unfortunately, I had to cut my ride in the kayak short. The position that you have to have your legs in the boat with them slightly raised was just really painful for me because of my bad hips. So unfortunately, I couldn't carry on because I was going to cry. But Si, I think, is quite happy to go on a little adventure on his own. You can see him off in the distance now. I'll show you. That's him, that little boat there. Here he is, coming into shore. Hey, how was it? Oh, great. We'll stay there, I'll get a little shot of that, that's nice. So, Si, tell everyone where we've just been.
Huh?
Where have you just been?
Paradise. To Lake Angora, which is a lake off Emerald Bay.
Yeah. Can I just amend your answer?
Yeah,
we've been to the upper Lake Angora, and this here now is the lower one. So there's two small lakes in this Angola area.
Very true.
Angora area.
Now we're going to Markledale.
Now we're going to our next Airbnb, and this is the one that we're most excited about because in the pictures it looks so great. But we know that the area is quite remote and right in the country. Excited.
And it's a super host too, Jean.
Jean.
She's very looking forward to us, isn't she?
I hope so.
Is it going to turn into like a horror film?
Yeah, the visit.
On the face of it, she's super nice, and then weird stuff happens at night.
Well, we'll know in about 24 hours.
Ooh. Charge your batteries.
So this is the lower lake, which is utterly beautiful, but there's not much kind of beach space to relax on, but there's some really gorgeous cabins, as you can see over there.
That's where we were.
Yeah. Oh God, it's so good to go downhill. My earrings whistle in the wind, like the rings, create a weird whistling. We've arrived at our Airbnb in Markerville and we are completely overwhelmed. It's absolutely incredible, so I'm going to just show you quickly. It's unreal.